Hi everybody, today is the first official video for this next year, 2013. I'm going to have at least one video a day, talking about whatever, showing an example, just regular stuff. So the plan for it is each show will start off with a joke of the day, a song of the day, and a question of the day. And you can comment with your answers or just don't comment at all. Anyway, and then the show will go on. And then at the end of the show, I'll answer any questions that have been asked for the previous shows. And then once a week, I'll have a What We Need to Know Day. And I'll have guests come and either be on the phone or on Skype or whatever. And then we'll talk about the questions that were asked during the week or whatever. If someone asked for a specific topic to be discussed, then we'll talk about that. So that's the plan for this year, is to get this show going. So today, the joke of the day is, what do you call a dog with no legs? Thought someone answered. It doesn't matter what you call him, because he isn't going to come to you. Ha ha ha. I know, it's cheesy. The song of the day is this. Uno momento.
Work all night and a drink of rum.
Daylight come and we
want to go home. Stop banana till the morning come.
Daylight come and we
want to
go home.
Come, Mr. Tallyman, tally me banana.
Daylight come and we want
to go home. Come, Mr. Tallyman, tally me banana.
Daylight come and we want to go home.
Lift
6 foot, 7 foot, 8 foot, bunch.
Daylight come and we want to go.
6 foot, 7 foot, 8 foot, bunch.
Daylight come and we want to go. A beautiful bunch, a ripe banana.
Daylight come and we want
to go. Hide the deadly black tarantula.
Daylight come and we want to go.
If
6 foot, 7 foot, 8 foot bunch.
Daylight come and we want to go.
6 foot, 7 foot, 8 foot bunch.
Come, Mr. Tallyman, tally me banana.
Come,
Mr. Tallyman, tally me banana. Hey, oh, hey,
oh. Come and we want to
go.
Daylight come and we want to go.
Okay, so that's the song of the day. I was feeling very happy. The question of the day is, what are you most afraid of in the end of the world as we know it? So, like, for me, I guess that would be not being able to protect my family the way that I should need to. Okay, so today's show is a little questionnaire just to get us started for the year. I'll just ask those questions and I'll probably answer a couple of them. Anyway, just things to think about. And then if you want to answer them, you can, but it's just something for people to think about for the future. So let's get started. Number one, has your family planned or rehearsed escape routes from your home? Mine has kind of, but they haven't rehearsed it, and I don't think they will. Number two, does your family know what to do before, during, and after an emergency situation? Yes. My family knows. I guess just look to me. I've kind of taken leadership, and so it's kind of just ask me what to do. Do you have heavy objects hanging over beds that can fall during an earthquake? This one, I left it on there. Usually I don't put things for a certain disaster or anything, but this one I thought about because all growing up, well, the majority of growing up, I had shelves above, like, all around my room. And I always thought if an earthquake happened, the first thing that would happen is things would fall on me, and it scared me all the time. But now I don't, and neither does anyone else, because it's something to definitely think about. I know a lot of kids' rooms have the shelves by their beds and stuff, and that's nice and all, but I don't think that doll would be as lovely when it falls on your face. Number four, do you have access to an operational flashlight in every occupied bedroom? I got all fancy with that one. No. I have one. My mom has one. But my brother does not, I don't think. However, he does have his laptop on the majority of the time, so I think if something happened, the first thing he would do is move that so there's some kind of light coming from that. I don't recommend using candles immediately. Like, let's say an earthquake. I say earthquakes all the time because we're in California. So let's say an earthquake happened. I would not use a candle immediately because I'm not sure if there's a gas leak. So I'd use a flashlight, get everything finalized, and then start using candles. Number five, do you keep shoes near your bed? I do. My mother kind of does. The baby doesn't. Well, technically they're by his bed. And my brother does. So everybody. Six, do you know how to shut off the main water line to your house? No, I don't. I live in an apartment, so I'm not sure if we even can shut off this stuff. I'll have to figure it out. Seven, can this water valve be turned off by hand without the use of a tool? I don't know. Do you have a tool if one is needed? I can get one. Number eight, do you know where the main gas shutoff valve to your house is located? No idea. If you smell gas, do you know how and would you be able to shut off this valve? No idea. This is not sounding good. 10. Gas valves usually cannot be turned off by hand. Do you have a tool near your valve? Nope. I need to figure out the gas, water, and stuff. Do you have working smoke alarms in the proper places to warn you of fire? Yes. I think we have one in every room and the hallway and the kitchen. Carbon monoxide alarms? I actually don't know. They might detect that too. I have to check. Do you have a fire extinguisher that you know how to operate? No. The fire department will test yours for free. I found that out just recently, that the fire department will test yours and make sure that it's working good, and they don't charge you. So I put that in little itty-bitty quotes. Do you have duplicate keys and copies of important insurance and other papers stored outside your home or in your box? I don't think we have the duplicate keys yet. In fact, that reminds me. I don't recommend going to Walmart to get keys duplicated. We went, gave them two keys, not like some big wad of keys, two keys. We wanted copies of each key. We asked for three copies of each. Neither one of them, none of the keys that they gave us, worked on any doors in the house. None of them. It was ridiculous. So, that's why we don't have keys, because we forgot to go back. We do have copies of important papers and stuff, but the majority of the papers that should be copied are not in our bobs at all, actually. God, I gotta do that. Okay. Do you have a functional emergency radio to receive emergency information? Yes. Yes, I do. If you and your family had to evacuate your home, have you identified an outside meeting place? Yes, kind of. Yeah, you could say yeah. 17. Would you have sufficient food for a month? Yes. 6 months? Maybe. A year? No. Would you have the means to cook food without gas and electricity? Yes. I'm not sure. Everyone say hi to my brother, you big wimp. Sorry, my brother likes to come in and out. So, 19, would you have sufficient water for drinking, cooking, and sanitary needs for a month? Yes. 6 months? No. And not even close to a year. We went on a trip, and I was going to get water before the trip, and my mom said, no, we're going to be gone anyway, it won't matter. I didn't think so. But so we went on the trip, and when we came back, we just got back not too long ago, and we still don't have the water that we need to replace. We probably need a good more 20 gallons. I try to get at least, 6 or 8. I have a problem with getting odds. I like to get doubles. I guess it's like an OCD thing. But yeah, so I need to get some probably tomorrow. And I'll probably get 20 gallons. I also have a bad habit of going and getting brand new bottles instead of going and getting them refilled, even though it's 90 cents for a gallon, but it's only 10 cents, 15 cents, whatever it is, to get it refilled. So I should probably think about doing that. But some of the bottles that we get, we either get the ones you can just pop the top off, or we get the screw-on ones. And I would refill the ones that turn, but I don't think I would refill the pop ones. Where was I? Do you have access to a 72-hour evacuation kit or a bug-in bag? Yes-ish. Not for everyone. I try to have a bag for everyone, like bug-out bags and get-home bags, but I do not have bug-in bags for everyone. So I'll be doing that this year. Would you be able to carry or transport these kits? Yes. Have you established an out-of-state contact? No. See, the problem with my family is my family doesn't really support me in this. They act like it's a joke or just a phase that I'm going through. But it's been quite a long time that I've been doing this, and they still don't support me like I wish they would. So, I mean, that's kind of the bummer with things like that. Especially a lot of, I have family on the coast, so it's kind of like, there's a lot of possibilities that could happen where my family is. And it scares me because they don't take it seriously. So I've just kind of chalked it up as a loss already. And it's sad to say that, but I can't waste my time worrying about someone who doesn't take it seriously when I have to worry about the people here. So, anyway. So we don't have an out-of-state contact yet. Do you have a first aid kit in your home? Yes. We do. In your car, we are supposed to, but I took it out because I wanted to redo it. And each bug out bag, we have a small first aid kit. We more so have a bag, like a first aid bag, and it has stuff for like medicines, scalpels, surgery equipment. I don't know, there's a lot in there, but what is it? It's a lot of crap. So I'll probably show that to you guys in another video. Do you have work gloves and tools for minor rescue or cleanup? I'm gonna say yeah. We do have work gloves. And I guess we kind of have tools. Kinda. Do you have emergency cash on hand? Yes. I keep amounts of cash everywhere. And, recently, I've been doing the $1 bills kind of thing, and recently I've been doing the coins, keeping coins. So, like, when I go to a store or whatever, and I'll get the quarters and change, you know, I'll just go through my wallet maybe once a week, take out all the quarters, and then set them aside for whatever situation. Without electricity and gas, do you have means to heat at least part of your house? No. If you need medications, do you have a month's supply on hand? Yes. 6 months, no, and a year, no. I don't take medications really, but I used to have diabetes. I had pre-diabetes, and then during my pregnancy, I had gestational diabetes. So I kept a lot of my medication that I was taking. Anyway, it helps with your blood sugar. So I kept a lot of that hidden away. And when we first moved here to Bakersfield, I was getting a lot of infections, actually. I got inflamed tonsils and a lot of ear infections, throat infections. It was like something was not right, but that was just when we first moved here. So they were giving me antibiotics a lot. So I keep all my antibiotics that I haven't used, I keep those away. My mom, she has high blood pressure and quite a few other things wrong. And I haven't really talked to her about her medications yet. We're kind of working on stuff little by little. I haven't talked to her about that yet. So that's something I need to get done, because I know some of her medications are very important, and she actually has to pay for all her medications. She doesn't have any insurance, so it's kind of like, I don't even know if we could get that much, because really right now we're not doing too great financially. So, but you know, if it's something, a necessity, if she has a medication that is dire to her health, then I will do what I can to get it for her. We do not have 6 months or a year for medications. Do you have a plan for toilet facilities if there's an extended water shortage? Yes. That's a tough one, because it's something that we all don't really want to talk about. It's one of those things, kind of keep it private, but it's actually really important. We have a couple different ways that we can dispose, but we don't have the options that I would like. I do keep a lot of extra bathroom stuff, like toilet paper, wipes, different things, shampoos, conditioners, soaps. Pretty much everything. Like, for instance, we went to the hotel room for our holiday, and we were there for a while. And when we left, you know, they leave the soaps and the toilet paper and different things. You know, they leave extras around. So, take it back, put it in a bag, keep it away, and I am positive that it will come in handy sometime. And I had some old shampoos and conditioners and some body washes and different things, because my mom used to work for Avon, so she, you know, she always had the body washes and shampoos and all this different stuff around. So I have some of those saved up. Just different, you know, different things. I do keep all of my grocery bags for toilet facilities, just in case. I don't know if we still have the small shovel, but if worse come to worse, then that would be an option, is just bury it and forget about it. And the last question is, do you have a supply of clothing or fuel? I think that was supposed to be two different questions. So let's start. Do you have a supply of clothing for a month, 6 months, or a year? Yes and no. I say yes because for adults it's easier. But my son is 21 months and he's growing really quick. And I have not taken the time to actually get clothes that will fit him. I mean, he has a couple clothes that are bigger that he would fit in, but I have not really taken the time to get clothes that he will grow into later on. So that's something I need to work on. Do you have a supply of fuel? No. Not for a month, not for 6 months, and not for a year. It's hard right now on us as a family financially to go out and be able to do what I wish we could do. Or get what I wish we could get. Our car is a great little car, but fuel is really expensive right now. And I don't feel it where we are right now. I don't even feel comfortable saving fuel and keeping it somewhere, because really our house doesn't really have a space where it would safely be held. So we do not have fuel. Anyway, so that is the questionnaire. I guess if you're on my group on Facebook, then I'll post the questionnaire there. And you can get it there if you want it. Or if you're not and you don't want to go to that length of adding me on your group, so you could email me, I guess. Yeah, why not? I'll put my email underneath, as well as the joke, the link to the song of the day, and the question of the day. I'll put it all in the, you know, the little section down there. Just look where my finger is pointing. Anyway. So this is my New Year's resolution, is to actually get this going and stay dedicated to it and not give up. So I hope this made you think, and I hope my song made your day. Much love and Happy New Year. All right, bye.